In this video, I want to have a look at the VIP system in State of Survival. So the VIP system can give you extra benefits in a variety of ways. And besides those benefits, it also gives you a free chest daily. In addition, you can also purchase certain chests from the VIP once you have reached a certain level. I haven't really paid attention to that because I'm not a spender. So yeah, if you want to have a look at that, you need to decide for it yourself. So the benefits you can get are can be divided in different categories. So one is related to construction speed and an instant construction time. At VIP 4 you get 10% construction speed, and at VIP 9 that is increased to 20%. The instant construction time is increasing with 1 minute each level. Of course, as the timers become longer, the construction speed increase is much more important than those few minutes extra that you get. For me, the construction speed of 10% is a main factor in keeping my VIP active. 10% is quite significant, and the construction timers keep becoming longer and longer, so 10% definitely helps there. It seems in the end it's not that difficult in this game to reach headquarters 30 and to unlock tier 10 troops. At least I'm well on my way, about to start headquarters 29. So at a certain moment, that construction speed boost might not be so interesting anymore. But as you increase your VIP further, there are other benefits as well that I want to have a look at. The resource production and storage protection, they are relatively small. And resource production is not that important. Gathering is much more important. So those I find not so interesting. Squad backpack capacity that will increase from here onwards. That is quite interesting because normally that's for your hero explorer missions, and I would really like to set that to auto, but at the moment I don't have enough capacity, so I'm missing out on rewards, so I'm more or less forced to walk through that manually, and that just takes time that I can spend on something else. So that's a bit annoying, and one extra slot doesn't really make a huge difference, but if you get more and more, that will definitely be helpful. VIP 7, you get extra troop formation. That is your march preset, I like to call it. Currently I have 2, so an extra one will always be beneficial. You have maybe different type of combats that you want to do, so you can have different slots to experiment a bit. That's always nice. At VIP 8, a very important one, an extra march slot, or at least very important. It allows you, for me, the main benefit of extra march slots is that I can do more resource gathering simultaneously, so you get more resources. So that's beneficial. I also don't know whether that is going to be that crucial, because so far research seems to require a lot less resources than construction. And with construction, once I reach headquarters 30 and I've upgraded all my buildings to 30, I'm a bit afraid that after that resources will not be an issue in going further, but you're going to need rare items that you need to purchase to get further. So I'm also not yet completely sure whether resources will be a huge issue. After here you get some combat boost, troop defense, which will later at VIP 10 and 11 troop attack and health will be added as well and go to a total of 16%. That's definitely nice. Quick switch equip I'm going to skip because I don't think that's really relevant, because we only have combat gear in this game, not economy gear like in some other games. This is used to switch between two different gear sets, like combat gear and economy gear, but that's not relevant here, so I'm not really sure what it does here. But some things in this game are just not working or not relevant. I think they have copied too much from other games. The last thing that you get in VIP 12, which is very interesting, is the quick switch talent. not something that is going to make you a lot stronger, but that means that by one click you can switch between two talent tree presets. Currently I'm spending a lot of time, but daily, practically daily, I'm switching between a war talent tree configuration and an economy talent tree configuration. And this way, instead of having to do all that and select all those projects again and again, here you can just do that once and then switch with one click. So that's definitely a huge benefit. The problem is you probably need a huge amount of points to get to here. I think so far I don't really know what you get, what you need, like 40,000 for VIP 6, and somebody told me 350,000 for VIP 9. For the rest, I don't really know what is required, so I can only guess that if VIP 9 is already 350,000, probably we're looking at least 2 million, maybe more points required for VIP 12. Besides the benefits of these boosts and skills that you unlock, you also get a free chest every day, which is quite interesting. At VIP 12 you get 6 legendary hero fragments. That's quite nice. At VIP 7 that start the legendary hero fragments start at with 1 VIP 7 and 8 1 VIP 9 and 10 2 VIP 11 3 VIP 12 6. So that's quite nice. Or very nice. You also, before that, you get some epic hero fragments. But I think also without this VIP bonus, you will be able to max out all the purple heroes that you want within too long of time. So not really a big requirement. You get chief XP points. That is quite nice to get some extra. But at the moment, I get 2,000 at the level where I'm at. I get 2,000 chief XP points per day, while I need 200,000 to get to the next level. So it's not a huge amount, but it helps. So based on what I've seen, there are some considerations. So do you want to activate VIP or not? Because just increasing is not good enough. You also can decide, do you want to keep it active or not? For me, the construction speed boost is a reason to keep it active at the moment. I use 30-day VIP items for 10,000 biocaps. That's in my eyes worth it. So now and then I do get 24-hour VIP, so I can use those when my 30 runs out, and then once those are run out as well, I do another 30 days. So that's quite nice also for the benefits that I get. I mean, at this moment it is still, even though I can I said I get these epic heroes, I can max them out anyway. It's nice to get the extra fragment and badges and the chief XP. So I think there are reasons enough to keep it active at VIP 4, even at VIP 5 as well. And the higher you go, the more reasons there are to keep it active. That's it for the VIP. Did I forget anything? No, that's it. As I said, not all boosts are very important or as important as others, but in overall, definitely worthwhile to go for it. I'm still looking to get the VIP requirements for higher levels. You can, by the way, on my website, you can see the details, the detailed boosts of every level and the contents of every chest in a quick overview, so that you can easily compare things. I was saying I still need the VIP point requirements of higher levels. If you happen to know those, if you could share them with me via a comment on YouTube or on my website, that's always much appreciated. And thanks for watching this video.